Listen, this is going to be some kind of show. WYNK, the Kings of New York are here. We are here for you on this, the worst day in Yankee baseball history. I'm the fat man, Joey Lucco. This is Richie Grivaldi. Richie, I'm disgusted. I'm disgusted with this baseball. I'm done. I'm done with them. I'm telling you right now, I swear to God on my mother's grave, I'll never watch another Yankees game in my life. I'm done with them.
You made some really good points about Brian Cashman yesterday. It's time to do away with Brian Cashman as head of the Yankees. He's got to go.
Listen, get a Theo Epstein in here. What about Cashman? We had him for 50 years now. I'm sick of him. I'm sick of his face. I don't want to see his face no more. I don't want to see, you know what? So I don't want to see his bald head. It's Brett Gardner. I'm done with his scrunchy face.
Done with Brett Gardner.
Brett Gardner's
done. We're done with Brett Gardner.
And what the hell? Cashman, yeah. What are you bringing in here? I'm so tired. Man. Rucknet. What is a Rucknet? I never heard of a Rucknet. By the way, I'm done with Gleyber, too. I'm done with him. I don't even know what a Gleyber is. It's something that you change on your car.
Slow down.
It's not. Listen.
Kid's 18.
Hey, my Gleyber's out. Are you going to cost me $300? Get out of here. I'm not fixing
my
Gleyber.
He's 18 years old. We got to let the kid
have a chance to develop. I'm done with all of them. What happened to the good names like Derek and Bernie? And we had the Mick and Joe D. No, we got a Gleyber and a Ruck. Get out of here with this team.
You know, I'm the biggest Garrett Cole truther out there. You know how I am with that. I was so happy when we signed him. I think this is really on the Yankees organization. The ownership, the GM. Listen, you got a barbaric rule about cutting people's hair when they get to the team. You can't have facial hair. You got to cut your hair. So let me ask you this question. If you knew that a guy's strength, if you took Tyson's, if you cut his wrist off, he said you can box,
nothing.
But you can't have a fist. He's not knocking anybody out with the nub. No one's getting knocked out with the nub. And so we're sitting here looking at Garrett Cole, the beautiful long flowing hair with the Astros, just killing teams.
Yeah.
Where's that guy? You've got to stop the rule of cutting the hair. You're killing Garrett Cole.
No,
it's not his fault. And you took him out. And honestly, Fats, I don't know what you think on this. I thought you took him out too early. I thought the guy was just starting to hit his groove.
Garrett Cole, you're a bum. Beat it, all of you. We got a caller here. It's Billy down in the Bronx. Billy, what you think?
Guys, these Yankees, they suck. They suck. They couldn't hit their way out of a paper bag. You know what? Steinberg, sell the team. Get rid of the team. It's a joke now. 12 years, no World Series. Get out of here.
You've made a lot of good points there. I'm Richie.
Couldn't hit.
He made a lot of good points.
Couldn't hit.
I swear to God. Last night, my little beautiful Angela, it's not her real name, it's Antoinette, but I call her Angela because she's my little angel. I'm putting her to bed, and she says, Daddy, are we going to win tonight? And I says, yes, my baby, we're going to win. Now shut up and go to sleep so Daddy can watch a game. Can she talk? Yeah. She don't shut up this one. My other kids, they're rotten, but I love my little Angela. Yeah. And now I lied to her. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. You fool me 1,000 times, Yankee. I'm done. I was born at night, but I wasn't born last night. You suck. The whole organization sucks. I'm done with you.
Fats, they disrespected your daughter. It's one thing for you to come at Richie Grivaldi and you say, we're going to make you look bad from your radio predictions yesterday, Richie Grivaldi. It's another thing when you come after this man's daughter.
Tommy's calling us. Let's get him in here. He's from Long Island. Let's get Tommy on the phone. Hey, Tommy, what's going on?
How's it going, Tommy?
Yeah, guys. I mean, I've been so depressed. I thought this was our year. You had Cole on the mound. You got that Judge. You got Stanton. All them. I haven't slept a wink because I've been up crushing beers because the Sox took it. Yeah, Yankees.
Oh my God.
You couldn't take it. Hey, listen. You had to.
Do yourself a favor. Touch your mom.
You're the worst of Boston.
You know, can you imagine?
That was Boston Billy.
That was Boston Billy. Called again.
Yeah, screw him. Hey, would Bucky Dent have lost to the Red Sox? No.
Never in a million years.
May he rest in peace.
No, he was at the game last night. They have video of him. Yeah, he's alive.
Listen, I might be faster than Judge. I'm telling you right now. And I'm the fat man. He's the slowest. And here's Nevin. Nevin, the number one overall pick that sucked. Why is he even coaching? He couldn't play a lick. And we're going to put him at third base. And we want this guy telling who's going to run home. He was the worst. He was one of the worst picks in baseball history. He's the Jermunchy Russell of baseball picks. And he's going to tell Aaron Judge when to run. Oh, look who's here. This is our friend. One of the best. He knows the game. He's got all the inside information. He's Tony Hatchett, man, calling in to the show. Tone. The Yankees suck. I'm sorry.
Hey, Batman, what's going on?
How you doing, Tone?
Batman, I'm with you. Everything that you and Richie have said today is exactly what we're feeling in the Hatchett household right here, the Valentines. I swear on everything that if you don't get rid of Phil Nevin, this guy is like, have you ever seen an old poodle where their eyes cloud over with glaucoma, they get real foggy, you can barely even see the eyeballs. It just looks like one big gray cloud, and the poodle's running into the wall, and you're like, oh my God, for God's sake, can this poodle die? This is how I feel about Phil Nevin. This guy's been doing this all year. I know you and Richie have talked about it on multiple occasions. Nevin has got to be put down like that old poodle. I'm so curious at Phil Nevin. This guy is a bum. You've got to get rid of him. Passman, I'm done with him. He doesn't know how to build a team at all. I'm done with Gardner. Like you said, Brett Gardner, are you kidding me? Gardner should have been gone a long time ago. This guy does not represent us. And then finally, Garrett Cole. Are you kidding me? This guy is softer than a nun's panties. And he's sitting here wearing the stripes, embarrassing the entire city. Every borough in New York hates this guy. Every borough, and you know, no disrespect, Richie, but you're absolutely wrong on this one. Has nothing to do with the hair. This guy probably shaves his hair downstairs, if you know what I mean.
Whoa.
He's probably one of these manscapers. That's Tell me I'm lying.
Oh, I swear to God, he probably does that stuff. No, I leave mine go. You let it go. Come on.
Listen, I'm so furious right now. One of the reasons is because, as you guys know, I have inside information with the Inside Sports Syndicate. I am not allowed to give my inside information to the Yankees because they will arrest me for collusion or whatever that's called, insider trading with the Yankees. Oh, but you can go to a split. There's a place on the internet called the Fan Graphs.
Mm-hmm.
And what it is actual fans making actual graphs that teams are allowed to use. These could be fans of the Astros. These could be fans of the Red Sox. And you're using the graphs from fans of different teams, but you can't use. How about this, Fetch? Do you think the Yankees would like to know this? We were digging around on information, and we were digging around on a lot of different statistics and whatnot. And we came up with this nugget. Garrett Cole had allowed 5 home runs in Fenway Park this year. You think the Yankees would have liked to know that before they throw this cupcake out there?
Yeah, I'm sure they would. But, hey, they don't know nothing. They're too stupid. Listen, if they had your information, you know what? They're moving on to play them Rays. I'm telling you right now, Tone, I wish they had your info. But you can't listen.
I swear on everything. I'm going to be on tomorrow with Fats and Richie in my same spot as always. I got some winners for you. I told you guys the G-Man. How about the G-Man coming through? That's the only good thing that happened this week, the G-Man coming through. And you guys keep killing the Kings of New York. I appreciate it. We'll see you tomorrow.
That's Tony the Hatchet Man right here.